Star Trek Beyond is the third Star Trek movie in the new rebooted universe that started back in 2009. The other two movies were directed by J.J. Abrams. This one is directed by Justin Lin. You may recognize his name from the Fast and Furious movies. In this one, we have the same cast and crew that we had from the previous two movies. Chris Pine, Zachary Quinto, Zoe Saldana, Carl Urban, Simon Pegg. The story is, in this one, Kirk and the Enterprise are 3 years into a 5-year exploration voyage. On the way to help assist a ship in need, a ship that crash lands on another alien world, they get attacked by some mysterious villain named Krall, played by Idris Elba. He attacks their ship, he destroys their ship, and the crew is stranded and scattered on this alien world. So they have to band together, find a way to survive, and then find a way to stop Krall, who has a nefarious plot that he's working on against the Federation. Does anybody remember that really shitty trailer that we got, the first Star Trek trailer for this movie? Anybody remember this one?
Let's hope this doesn't get messy.
This is where it begins, Captain.
Yeah, trust me, it makes sense. It totally makes sense. In fact, they couldn't have picked a better choice. This was a really fun-ass movie, guys. Really, I enjoyed the hell out of this movie. I almost loved this movie. This one is a little bit more character-driven than the other Star Trek movies. Fans of the original Star Trek series, they'll appreciate that. It's not just about the big summer action blockbuster stuff this time. It's about the characters. Characters are put into really adverse situations, and they get split up, and they get paired up with people that you would never think they would get paired up with. Chris Pine and Zachary Quinto as Kirk and Spock, they're still great. The cast is all great. All the performances are really, really good. The best pairing that I like in this movie was Spock and Bones. They get paired up in this movie, and they definitely had the best moments of the entire movie for me. It was so great seeing these two characters that are so completely different having to spend more time together. Scotty was teamed up with this new badass chick that I'll talk about in a second. Spock and Bones on their journey together. That was some pretty cool shit. Pretty funny shit, too. So this is a movie that feels like it's both a mix of the movies that came before it, like in this new modern day reboot, but it also feels like it pays good homage to the original Star Trek shows. I mean, it feels in a lot of ways like a Star Trek episode. It's a little bit of a smaller story, a little bit more self-contained. If you're a hardcore Trekkie, you're going to like that type of shit, that they actually do start asking some of those deeper questions in this movie. They don't answer all of them, they don't spend a lot of time on them, but they at least ask them. The movie has some really good action sequences. Special effects and the action sequences, very well done. Justin Lin, you did a good job with this one, buddy. You really did. Let me talk about this badass chick. New character that they meet on this alien world named Jayla. She is completely badass. I loved her character. I would love to see her character going forward with the crew. I think it's the same chick from that Kingsman movie. I'm not 100% sure on that, but I'm pretty sure it's the same chick from the Kingsman movie. She was badass in that movie. She was badass in this one. Jayla. When you go see Star Trek, you'll know what I mean. She's pretty cool. It's a movie that is a fun ride. It's a fun summer blockbuster, so it's entertaining throughout. There's enough humor. There's enough action to satisfy you. If you're a Trekkie, you're going to be satisfied. I feel like this is the most well-rounded, I guess, of these new modern-day reboots, you know, because it can make everybody happy. I have a couple of nitpicks that I'd like to mention. Krall. Now, I didn't mention anything about this because I wanted to make a bigger point. Idris Elba as Krall, he was intimidating, he was menacing. I really, really liked him as the villain Krall. But I feel like he should have been given more to do. I feel like he doesn't get as much time in the movie as I wanted him to. He was so badass that I had to take credit away from the movie because they didn't make him as badass as I wanted them to make him. It also takes an incredibly long time for us to figure out what his plan is and figure out what he's after and what his motivation is. By the end of the movie, you go, oh. But at the same time, that just means I spent like an hour and 40 minutes going, why is this guy here? What is his plan? What is he doing here? What's the point of all of this? So I just think that Krall, while he was awesome, could have been better developed, could have had more time spent on him. And some of the humor didn't work for me, although that was probably because I had some really obnoxious fuckers behind me just laughing at every single thing, even if it wasn't funny. There's very few evils in this world that are bigger than the annoying moviegoer behind you who won't shut the fuck up. The pacing drags just a tad bit in this movie, and the pacing is definitely a lot slower than the previous movies. Justin Lin, even though he did a good job with the action, sometimes the action gets a little bit too shaky, a little bit too frenetic. You can definitely tell the difference between J.J. Abrams. It's not as sleek, it's not as stylistic, it's not as smooth as when J.J. Abrams is shooting the action. I was so close to giving it my highest rating, so close. I gotta stick to my guns. It's really, really good and almost great. I did enjoy this one less than the other ones, so I'm gonna give it the Man of Steel rating. Go out and see it, guys. Give your money. I think that fans are going to be satisfied with it. Stay tuned. I have a couple more reviews coming up tomorrow. Thank you, Kryptonians, for tuning in. And if you like what you see, tell me how you feel and stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. Peace.